So my topic today is actually sharing my own journey. So it's not like a sales talk or any particular topic. It's really on myself, from invisible to impactful to where I am today. So my name is Charlotte Mitsugi. I'm actually a full-time management accountant. So I have been in the industry, the account industry for 15 years, 10 years in the shipping line. So I spent about 5 years with NOL, leading a team of 5 analysts. And right now I'm the founder for LifeSparks Holdings Private Limited. We actually provide a series of fitness classes or wellness workshops and stuff to our corporate clients, as well as I work with the CSE Club or Safra Jurong Club to actually partner up with them for a series of fitness classes that they would like to launch. Like if they would like to launch some, like the latest strength class for Biloxing, Zumba, we could help them with that. So, and I'm the creator for my own website, which we had just launched this month. It's basically bringing out fitness and beauty into one website. And I'm also a primary school banks and POE specialist tutor. So I have about 15 years of experience. I do that on a part-time basis. So furthermore, I'm a fitness coach myself. So I not only have a pool of instructor helping me, I have all the certification to do the classes myself. So I'm FISA and IFA certified. I'm a licensed People Association trainer. I am a licensed Active SG trainer and vendor. So I run outdoor events. Like you can see, there's the free car days event. We also partner up with them. I'm a group aerobic instructor. It's about 5 years now. I'm a Zumba instructor. I'm the first Aqua Zumba instructor in Singapore. I flew over all the way to Australia to get my certification. I'm certified to teach Zumba Kids, Zumba Circuit, Zumba Center, Tony Go, and Zumba Step programs. I'm a Biloxing instructor since January 2015 when the program came to Singapore. I'm also a Biloxing Bar instructor recently in May when it came to Singapore by the company. And I'm the first Veraflow instructor, and the booty bar has just came into Singapore. So basically, bar program is something, it's a workout inspired from ballet. So if you have been dreaming to do ballet, you know, since young and don't have a chance, this workout is for you. Alright, so we take some of the movement from the bar program and we put it completely into a workout. So just found some fun, interesting facts about me. I'm actually a professional female international chess player. Okay, I spent like 10 years from since I'm 9 years old to all the way to 19 years old. I play international chess for the schools. Consecutive for 8 years, I'm a female champion in the various female category. So in 1995 and 96, I actually Singapore all the way to Malaysia for a tournament. So that was a great experience. And in 1999 to 2000, I was a president for Ngee Ann Polytechnic International Chess Club. So what do you think? That my life is really good, right? So all this achievement was really through a long journey and hardship that I went through. So just some of my humble beginnings. I started working part-time since I'm 16 after O-levels. I don't really come from a good family. My mom is here, all right? So she worked very hard. She had to work 3 jobs, all right, during when we are young to support myself and my brother. So my brother is also here. I think he's somewhere out there. Yeah, so in order to ease what she's doing, I have to work part-time. I go to actually office and just work a few hours to earn some money. Alright, during my days, I chose, after my O-levels, I chose to study diploma in accountancy in the Ngee Ann Poly instead of going to National JC. So I actually got a chance to go to National JC because my L1, R5 was actually just, I think it's 9. So I got a chance and I could actually diploma in accountancy because it was a fast track and I could still work. So that's my choice. And I had my very first business experience at the age of 19. I actually founded iMeet, something that I picked out of it. Alright, I got a chance to travel down to Bangkok, my very first trip down to Bangkok to actually take a look at what's there. And I happened to chance upon very, very cheap bags, like they cost about $5 to $6. And back then, there's still no movie screen. So for a youngster like me, I was like, wow, it's really cheap to have such bags. So I brought back about 20 of them. So when I brought it back, I was thinking, I can just put it in that time. Yahoo auction was really popular among us. So I load it up, I load 20 of them up, and it was sold out within a month. So 3 months later, I traveled down back to Bangkok using the money that I earned. I brought back another one quick luggage of bags. So that's how the business grew. But as you know, Yahoo auction is no longer there, so it's about 1 or 2 years it went down, and eBay came on. So I moved on, me and my mom, we got a chance in year 2001. There was a shop just right across my house. So we thought maybe we could just open a stationery shop and I could display some of the bags as well that I still left. And looking at this, a neighborhood in SA. So why not we bring in some toys? Why not we bring stickers that kids like? And then we even have like teachers coming to our stores and asking us if you can prepare all the stationery in bags. So that was the sort of a business opportunity just pop up when the store opened. So me and my mom was like busy, okay lah, got deals, right? Then we tried to come up with something. But that was 2 years and then I graduated. So I got a job. So we actually chose to give up the store so that my mom could do her own stuff. So I started working, but I still, so with a diploma, right, in Singapore, you can't really survive with just a diploma cert. So I have to study. So I couldn't afford to actually go down to NTU or NUS. So I chose an easier way is to get a CCA, all right, which is more affordable for me because I could work and pay off bit by bit. So, and I also give tuition. That is where I started my tutioning experience. So I could give tuition like 2 times in a week and during the weekends to just supplement the cost fee that I'm paying. So from there, at the age of 23, after about 3.5 years, 4 years, I obtained my ACCA cert and I got a chance to get a double degree, which is I obtained a second upper class master degree from Oxford University. So that was my certification. If you could just take a look at this few picture, if you could spot me. So it's really different for me. Yeah, it's really different. The first picture is in primary school. So with the type of education that I have, actually I'm pretty smart, but I'm not good looking. So even I top number one from primary 3 to primary 6, teachers don't really think so highly of me. What if you are top number one, you are not the sweet young thing or cute student that I have in class. The second picture, actually I'm right here. This person here, really ugly. Alright, so this is a chess tournament setting, alright. I'm always on the, if you are into chess, alright, the so-called a better player or the leader, the team leader of the team will always be on the desk. Or I can choose to strategize and sit on other tables. Alright, so that's what we do. The third picture is where I work in Famous Amos. Alright, so that was my part-time job that I took up during my poly life. So 3 years in poly, I took up this part-time job because it's really flexible. The manager right at the corner there, she gave me a lot of flexibility. If my lectures end at 4 p.m., she could let me work from 5:30 when I rush to Orchard all the way to closing. So that is how I earn based on the flexibility that she gave me. So, and I am really fat since I'm young. Yeah. So, 2 more pictures. Can you spot me now? Yes, no. Alright, so one is the extreme left. This is when the days that I'm in NOL. So these are my colleagues. ago, and this is when I traveled down for a business trip to India. So we have a visit to the Taj Mahal. So really starting to put on a lot of weight. It's that constantly working, constantly having supper. Alright, because we have to work, my job scope, I'm a management accountant, so we need to serve US and Euro timing. So we need to wait for the conference call. So very often we need to eat. And that is really unhealthy because you don't go out, you just stay in the office, wait for the supper, and you sit there most of the time. So that is what I've become, right? So, and yes, this is me. This is really the close-up picture. Really, I mean, this is the very first time that I speak about it. Normally, the story, the picture, most of my students have not saw. They know my story. Like one of my students is here today. Yeah, she knows my story, but like she's here because she had not hear entirely the full thing and saw the picture. So this is really me. And all right, I just want to pose a question here. For people, if you enter a lift, alright, every day enter a lift with a bunch of people, what's the first thing that you do? Anyone? Touch your hair? Touch your hair? How about you? Press the button. Anyone else? What do you do? Huh? Go to the corner. Okay. Anyone else? No? How about you? No reaction. Alright, for me, right? This lift actually looks very alike. I chose this picture. It looks very alike to NOL Day, alright, the office that we have in Alexandra. Alright. Every morning, my 5 years there, I will walk into this lift with managers, directors, presidents. I will go right to the corner. I will go right to the corner. That is how I feel because I was really huge. Alright, so once I get in, I will go right to the corner. And then you will hear people like, oh, hi, are you? Good morning. You know, these are the very often what director or manager would greet the rest of the staff, but not me. So they will greet everybody else. They know the names of the people, but definitely not me. They don't even know that I exist or which floor this person or this person is in the lift also don't know. Alright, so that was how I felt. Really, through this picture, it really reflects how demoralizing. And it's in the morning, it's really every morning, on Monday to Friday, you go inside this lift, you can feel that type of emotion. So talking about my topic today, so you know my background, why this topic today, right? So from invisible to impactful, so how I change myself or make that decision to change. So I want to share about the first one, I make a decision. So constantly for about 3 years, 3 years down the road in the company, I feel that I cannot take it anymore. It's too draggy. Drag a bit to the office and you work so hard. It's like I work equally hard with the rest of the manager. You work OT, I also work OT, you know? There's no reason why you get promoted and I don't get promoted. It's like, 为什么我没有机会? Like, I get all the certs that is required. I have all the experience in the accountancy. Like, why? Why is it not me? And I can see my fellow managers, they are climbing up very fast. They are climbing up very fast and I'm still stalking my way through. It's just a 9-to-5 job. So I was just thinking, is it because of my size or is it because of my image? Because definitely it's not my capability because I can deliver work very fast. Right? All my bosses can give a lot of good testimonial. Why they don't even know my name? So I was thinking, okay, already 3 years in this company, already 7 years in the previous company, I already coming to 30 years old. I need to do something about it. So I started to think, maybe, you know, since the company subsidized some workout class during lunchtime and the evening time, why not I just pop by and just do something instead of just staying to eat supper and wait for the conference call. I could just go down to a 1 hour class with the instructor, since it's just $5, around subsidized by the company. So I just pop down and come back up. So that is where I made a decision to start to exercise. So the first thing I did was some exercise. The second I did was after I go to went to the class, get to know some friends. So they were saying, maybe you can take a little change of eating habits. So I was thinking, yeah, maybe I shouldn't eat the zha cai feng, you know, every day zha cai feng. Then those oily bihun and stuff. So I start to change. I make my own breakfast. I start to read online what are the recipes that So a lot of decision making, changing the way that I dress instead of just going to random mall to buy those things. Like, you know, it's not your size, it's just you feel comfortable wearing it. And then those longer skirts, but I'm so short, right? So I'm so short, so it's not like puta, you know, you really puta. So I start to change, so maybe I buy a dress, a dress, you know, and I look more pleasant. So that was some of the things that I did. So in the midst of exercising, the more that I do, I found actually not too bad, I can sustain. So I did it from once a week, twice a week, every day. So every day I show up at the class, even lunchtime. So the second one that I did was I find a passion. So for me, it's through the exercise, the every day I was like going through, and then all the instructor was like, actually you do pretty well, you know, and then we see you every day. Want to try to go and take some certification, maybe take one basic aerobic certification and see if you are 吃着行饭, you know, you could just make this your another sideline. So I was thinking, ayah, 反正有空, accumulate like 40 over days of leave, right? So like, okay, now I take 1 week leave, I just give it a try, like, no, no harm trying. So that's how I find a passion. Now, the passion, what I did is constantly upgrading myself, and I got a chance to cover some classes. That is where I became a certified trainer, and I start to have a lot of followers, students that follow me through. At least I have like 20 over testimonials in the website that you can see that they have followed me through for 4 to 5 years. So it's since when I started. So how I grow the passion and gain the freedom that I want today is I actually making a business. So instead of just being a PA trainer, most in Singapore, everybody can still remain just a normal PA trainer. That means you are the only one teaching. But for me, I want to impact more women. I have guys in the class that's coming in as maybe like husband or for the wife or boyfriend, girlfriend. But mainly women are coming to the class, and I like to share, and I like to see the smile on their face. Like, I like to see my member Janet. Like, she's coming to my class and she's like, oh well, I want to be like you. No, I want to be as determined like you. You know, you might not see the result overnight because I'm not doing slimming here. It's not a slimming center. I don't promise result, but I will promise it's a journey. So this is me, alright, the before and after this. So this is another picture. This is really at my heaviest weight already. It's like beyond 70 already. So this is like 无可救药 already. They are a bit 无可救药 already. Like even my mom, like 这么肥, ayo. Like she will say, you 这么肥. Like actually it's quite demoralizing. Even not at workplace, right? Even in the family, maybe she will know that, like mommy will know, right? But feels a bit of full, like 不是我要这样的. Like 不是我要, like 不是我要这样子, you know? It's like the life in Singapore is you need a 9-to-5 job. Rather, you're educated in a way that you need the job to stay afloat. Right? I need the money. So that's me. So I'm doing a comparison here to show you in a nutshell what we have shared. So I'm still in a 9-to-5 job. So I'm not a full-time business owner. I'm not a full-time trainer. So I still work in 9-to-5 job. I have been headhunted to another shipping company. It's a ship management company, and I still do all my expertise, which is on the management accounting side. So it's still a 9-to-5 job. The only difference is now, instead of being invisible in the lane, I actually could greet people with confidence. So like all of you, I could stand here and talk to people. I could like approach my members and share with them. So that was really a huge difference here. No recognition in work, and I have a double promotion. Alright, so this part was just a sharing. So we were sharing about how nobody noticed me in the lift and stuff. So after I start to exercise, very surprisingly, 3 months down the road, I grew a bit slimmer. I look a little bit better for my skin because I eat better, because I eat salad. And no, I try to change a mix here and there instead of just rice. And I dress better. 3 months down the road, when I enter the same lift with the same group of people, people actually ask me, oh, which floor are you in? Can I press the button for you? So I was like, oh, okay, I'm on the 38th floor, thank you. And then, oh, you are Mr. Sin Lider, new girl. So I was like, Mr. Wan, actually I know you and I'm in the company for 5 years already. And I was like, oh my god, 5 years and I never see you. I said, you did see me. So, you know, that was the thing that they mentioned. So imagine a decision that I made has a very huge difference that I actually made in my career. So in the following few months, they start to notice that, oh, actually this girl has been in the company for 5 years, you know, she could deliver a lot of stuff and she handled so many projects that we didn't know. Alright, so in the following year, I actually got promoted. At the end of the year, I got promoted again. And I got a special bonus because of the project at home. Yeah, so that was really good. And then from a no hobby, no purpose in my life, it's just a 9-to-5 job, I actually found that I actually love to exercise. I actually discovered that I could teach and I could stand on stage today. If many of you are on like TV sometimes watching some of the advertisement or stuff, you could see me leading the stage, and I work with a lot of CCs to leading their mass workout as well. So that's something really different. Okay, it's just to recap, still 9-to-5. All of you have Facebook here? Yes, anyone know Facebook? No. Yes, all of you have Facebook, right? So from that, alright, I only have like less than 100 friends and families in my own personal Facebook when I was huge. Alright, very quiet, I don't really talk to people, don't go out. Till today, I have more than 1,500 friends, family, students, coaches, partners in the Facebook. So I'm not talking about, this comparison is not really talking about popularity. I'm more talking about, it gives me a lot of things. Because imagine, like me, I don't really have a chance to talk to my mom at times because she's busy with her own small passion business as well. So I tend to be independent from young. So the only chance for me to, you know, sometimes I share a little bit of things like, hey, okay, 这个地方很好吃, like 有好吃的东西, or, you know, I make a salad, you know, and somebody will comment like, oh, how do you do it? You know, all these small little comments actually meant a lot to me. Like, you know, you still have friends, you still have family. So this comparison was more to show that, alright? And the difference is there's none here because there's no other things that you can do. It's just a 9-to-5 job. And from Impactful, I'm actually a fitness coach today and a business owner. So I own a fitness dance studio and I also have a skincare business. Alright? Okay, so we're coming to the second part which I want to share. That was my own journey. If you are here today, I will hope that, you know, you can take away some stuff and see what you can do back into your own life or somebody's life that you think that they should hear this. Alright, so I chanced upon this small little message. It was taken with my handphone when I went to New Zealand for a trip. So it was saying that every great journey starts with a few small steps. I think it's really true. So I took this out of the window, so it was like a bit blur. So it was a moving vehicle. So I think it's true, and that leads me to share with you what's my 5-step strategy for you to take away today. So the first one I think is to identify your invisibleness. Alright, it's a word that I make out of. It's not, there's no such word, so I put it there. Alright, so it could be in the workplace like me. Alright, it could be in family. Alright, in your own family, you might be the maybe 排行中间, you know, and you don't really feel the love or, you know, the same love that share among the siblings, so you might face that. Friends, I think this is also very common because for me, I went out, when I'm huge, right, when I went out with my friends, they are pretty slim or very pretty. So you will be the only one very often left out. Yeah, like, most of the opinion where to eat or where to go or where to shop will be up to them. You don't really have a say. And for shopping wise, right, most of the clothes I can't wear, so only you can buy. Yeah, so that can be friendship. Within the colleagues, this is very common. Everybody out for lunch except you. Yeah, that is a form of invisibleness, right? People don't really care that whether you are sitting just next to me. I face that most of the time, so sometimes see another colleagues that just came into the company and they are facing the same thing, I can feel how she feels. Because it's like, oh, 我第一天来上班呢, and like nobody cares, you know, like okay, 一个星期了, eh? Still why like that, you know? So I tend to be a bit more friendly to colleagues that was being left out. So that's me. Alright, in businesses. So for businesses will be something like, you have very good products, you have very good service, you are very good at it, but you are lagging the... That will be linking to what James has said in the earlier session, how you can use marketing and sales to help you. So that is also a form of invisibleness. Okay. The second one is to make a decision. So very simple, this one is either, oh, 我都肥了,我不去肥哦, never mind. You know, it's like, you know, it's the same whole thing, you know, 我已经是不肥, then I just 不肥咯, you know, my skin is really bad, then just be it. You can make a decision, so you can choose to remain the same. You don't do anything. So your life will be just a 9-to-5 job, or you will just stay at home, you know. I just, I'm okay. I will just stay with whatever that I can. Or you can be like me. You make a decision and take action. So you really come to a point like 我受不了. It's like 我已经到尽头了. Like if I don't change, right, all my hard work, you saw how hard that I worked through my, after my O-levels, 存钱, everything, go and take a double degree. You know, I don't want my double degree to go to waste. I don't want my 10 years of experience in accountancy climbing my way through go to waste. So I take action. So it can apply to you if you take action today. Third point would be, if you take action, then you have to make changes. So I have a few key points that it could apply to one of you. So it could be exercise, like me. Alright, so choose to find some sports that you can do. It can be yoga, it can be Pilates, it can be playing basketball, it can be anything that is of interest to you, just to sweat it out. And it will actually release a little bit of happy pills for you. And eating habits, this is very important. Even though it's not to slim down, I think eating habits will actually improve a lot on your health condition. So many of my members, they actually come to me to just consult a bit of like what are some of the things they can change. You can see that they are actually not looking for slimming down. They are looking to maybe be a little bit more healthy so that they can be better. Because you know, if you eat too much sugar, actually you can see that your face will start to have a little bit more open pores as well. Yeah, so and proper skincare regime. So I can see people that they have actually very dull skin and they don't take care, they don't wash, they don't really have like proper washing of their face. So what they could do is just take action, start to have proper skincare regime. You don't have to buy really expensive stuff, you know? That's very normal stuff. Appropriate dressing. So I name it appropriate dressing is, I have an example here. Like you are in your workplace, and the boss or the company culture is to wear formal. So you really have to wear nice dress or so. And you actually can excel well in the job scope. You're actually a very good employee. But you just being stubborn. You wear t-shirt, you wear jeans, you wear track shoe to work. Alright, and your manager come about like, why do you want to wear that? The official attire is actually formal, alright? So that actually affects the performance. The performance appraiser was like all good except the dressing part. So why not you just take action and make the change? Why do you want to be stubborn? So that was just a simple example. Another one is speak up and share your ideas. For this, right, I'm talking about people in the meeting room. So it's like you can choose to be in the meeting room of 10 that is very normal in a corporate. We go to meeting very often. You'll be the one that will always just keep quiet. Okay, you know, it's like just let them go and speak up. I will just quietly hear and see what's the take action move by the boss. You know, I don't really need to say anything or be impressed. But deep down your heart was thinking, yeah, actually I have a very good idea. Or once the person, your colleague share, right, they was thinking, actually I have a better alternative to what you have shared. So I will encourage you to speak up and share your idea. You never know that action actually helps you in the next level of your career. Then fourth one will be find your passion. So there's a lot of ways to find your passion. So I will just go through a little bit, like maybe you love to sing, you go to KTV, K-box like almost every week or every 2 weeks. You could make singing your career. You can actually join or purchase like coupon, right? Like 4 lessons for $18, go for a singing course. From there, you never know. Maybe you could just join a singing competition, which is very, very, very common nowadays. Then you just realize that you are very good and you can be a superstar. Right? Or you just load your singing onto YouTube. That is a very simple and fast way to gain awareness. And we have making. This one has been very, very popular even in my own circles of friends. They love to make. So they actually find this a joy. They will come home from their 9 to 5 and they started to bake some new recipe that they have invented. They post it out on Facebook. Right? They post it out on Facebook and then they could share with the friends. And some of the friends actually say, yeah, maybe you can do this for my children next week birthday or something. Then slowly this one maybe become a business. You never know, right? So and then we have a few examples, writing, maybe writing a blog. Okay, I want to talk about computer games because this, we have a few gentlemen here. I know guys like to play games and I have an example that a boy like 18 years old loves to play games every day. You might, like most of the parents say they don't play games. But this boy actually become a millionaire by being a professional gamer. So anything could happen, right? You never know. A boy as young as 18 already become a millionaire. So cooking, same as baking. Makeup, you are very good with makeup. I think this is very common with the younger girls, alright? They actually show you how they make up, alright? And then load it out to YouTube and teach you the step-by-step tutorial. So this is pretty popular now. Traveling, you love to travel. You could actually start to write a traveling blog or traveling review. Yeah. So people are actually waiting for people to write this and they could form a book. Post review, I have friends who really love to post reviews about where she bring the kids, like going to certain eating place or shopping mall and post some reviews of the place, and she started to post on the mother forum. So I think last year she actually took up all the reviews and all this experience that she has into her own blog. So from there, she actually got a lot of vendors coming in to actually offer to her reader 10% discount, $100 voucher, giving a lot of goodies to her readers. So exercising, which is what I did, and coaching. So, and in the end, it's really to the individual, you could grow your passion and gain your freedom. So I would like to encourage you to find your passion and see what you are good at, and then grow it further and gain your own freedom. From there, I have a testimonial here. You must be thinking, is there anybody else that has followed your strategy and gained the same results? So I actually helped this girl, Miss Celine Liao. Alright, she came to me, a student of mine, came to me in late 2012. So she chanced upon my blog. I wrote a very simple blog about my weight loss just to keep myself motivated. So she chanced upon that. She came to me, she came to my studio. That's the first picture that I took with her. And she was weighing, this is more than 100 kg back then. Her. And then she joined me to the Ching Game. We, in 2013, we actually have a Ching Game parade for Zumba. So that she, alright, 100 kg, and she sent me her testimonial here. Okay, this her. This her. Alright, in 2009, and that is her when she already started the program with me for about 6 months. So you can see the significance. So can you guess how old is she in 2009? Anyone? I will give you a free gift if you guess correctly. In 2009, how old is she? Anyone? Anyone? I will give you a free water bottle. My the unique water bottle that is designed by me. No one want to guess. Janet want to guess. Janet's a high chance of guessing usually. Because you know her. No one want to guess? Alright. So she is only 20 years old in 2009. Look at this picture. 20 years old. I think if you don't know her, right, you're thinking this is a 4个孩子的妈 or something like that. Yeah, if you don't know her, maybe you would think that like, this is a 生过4个孩子的妈. Alright, so and she really worked her way through. I see her result in 6 months. And finally, this was the last picture that she sent me, that she formed this testimonial for me. She looks really amazing now. Right, and it's the very first time that she wore this dress because she was invited to be a bridesmaid for a best friend. Alright, and she was really very exciting, and so she's sending this picture straight away because it's the first time that she can wear like that. Do you think like this can wear that dress? Cannot lah, the cloth picture or not enough cloth. I think so, but she was really very happy that she could that someone actually approached her and say, 你可以做我伴娘吗? 可能这个人要她做伴娘吗? 对不对? Alright, 这个是人家 approach 她, 你可以做我伴娘吗? And she is really very pretty on that day. I'm very happy for her. So, and this is a testimonial that she sent me. It's on my website, so I have to rip it out from the website. You can read through, but I want to highlight that how she actually made use of the 5-step strategy. So it works. Alright, she actually said that she helped me to start off my fitness journey and make progression to my life. So she made that decision. She made the decision to start off a journey and then make progression to her own life. And then she talked about okay, this is fine. Alright. And then she took up my personal coaching, and that is where she start to know what to eat, what to do, what fitness class to attend. Not everybody attend the same class to have the same result. So you have to choose what to do, and then a well-balanced diet. I will not recommend crash diet. Alright, it's really through a well-balanced diet that you monitor your health and keep going. Alright, in total, right, she lost 22 kg in 1.5 years. 1.5 years, she lost 22 kg. She was saying it's so inspiring, changed her life drastically. And she, I think importantly, I like this sentence is she said that she developed more self-confidence in socializing with people. Because she is really a shy girl when she first came to me. Alright, even only me and her, right, face to face, she don't really talk that much. Yeah, so she really developed that. And I changed her image. I teach her not to wear t-shirt most of the time, to hide whatever, you know. Most of the ladies will say, I just want to hide whatever lah. Don't want to wear tight. But I chose some dresses that is really fitting. I chose things that really suits her. And find her own style. The most important is find your own style. A certain dress might look good in one lady, might not look good in her. So she has to find her own style. And that's where she stays. She eliminated my usual baggy t-shirt, sloppy look into a fitting size, pleasant image. So today, right, she is one of my coaches. So she took on the journey and I encourage her to be like me. Go and take on some courses to see if you are keen to walk this line with me. So she took on. And she said that I was trained to become an instructor, which I never thought I could be one. So, and the last sentence, I was really touched. She said, I want to inspire more women to be like me, just like what Charlotte had did for me. So, that's her. And I want to recap her picture. Some of you just came in. So, that's her in 2009. She's only 20 years old. So, if she don't make the decision in 2012, when she met me, she's 23 years old. Then she will be still like this. Still like this today. Alright? So and she won't be a coach today. She won't be wearing, and she won't be like invited to be a bridesmaid as well. So that's her. So and with that, right, and then this person is actually in the house today. So I would like to actually invite you up here. She's right here. Maybe she can say something to some of you because
hello everyone, I'm Celine. Yeah, this is me in 2009. Oh yeah, I want to make a comparison. I started a personal coaching with Charlotte, and through this coaching I learned quite a lot of things. Like for example on life, or many things on life, like how to be a better person or how to make yourself happier. Like I do a job, a 9-to-5 job too, and I'm an instructor. I'm an instructor and I'm earning like part-time instructor. I think she gave me a very good opportunity, like to be a better person in the sense that I can earn extra income, except for like a 9-to-5 job. Then with the extra income, I can go for traveling, because with a diploma, I'm just a diploma grad. With a diploma grad, I can only earn like about 2K per month. So that doesn't bring me to any extra income that I can spend. So with her inspiration, I motivate myself to be an instructor and do something for myself. So I want to take this chance, take this opportunity to thank her, to guide me through my sort of like 3 years, 4 years of my life. Yeah. Thank you, Charlotte.
The end of the talk, alright. I just want to I can start your journey. I'm here to inspire more people to realize what you can do in your life. Like, it's not just sitting at home or just a pure 9-to-5 job. I want you to make the decision, alright. Find something that you really like and action on it. And the last step, for step number 5 is really to the individual. I can only do so much. I can only start. I can only inspire. I can share. I can share what I do. I can share what Celine did. I can share a lot of student ladies in my classes, what they have went through, and that there's a lot of testimonial up in the website as well. So I want to thank you all. Is we started your journey, you create the miracle. So it's really a miracle for me and myself and Celine that we have come a long way through, and it's never easy. The weight loss doesn't happen within like 3 months or 6 months. It took me 1.5 years to 2 years. It also took Celine about 1.5 years, and we still have a lot to go. You know, we will never be the perfect body. Alright, in Singapore, you will never achieve a perfect body because a lot of good food. So we always have up and down, and we have to constantly watch what we do. If we eat a little bit more, we exercise more. So that's life in Singapore. So thank you very much, alright, for being here. Alright, I have a booth right behind this hall, and I'm also, if you are here today, and I'm also the last speaker, I have brought the whatever stuff that I am providing, a free body assessment for you to know more about your body other than just weight. So this is completely complimentary on my part, because I want you to take the readings away back with you. Since you are here back with you, you can go and assess like, oh, I have certain area that I need to improve on. So you can come down to the table right here on the left, and I have some of my coaches and member to help you with that. Alright, and you can speak to me if you have any questions as well. Thank you very much.